Non c'è che un bimbo che ha forse il problema è che non c'è niente di più di adesso. Sì, è tutto che lavora. È Cristo. Tu mi sei in termini volontari o non è?
This contactor 1 over 1 plus f, c
So, for the CNG is U to the power N minus P to the power G, 1 minus P to the power N minus G.
Can you use the same interest for 1 month or 1 year? So,
distance and the step away on n, so that the n plus n, n to the power n goes to e to the power the n or something t, where n goes to infinity. Of course, you have to relate the n and the t in the way. But you can pass to the limit to find that rules from it. From this story, that's super. Maybe it's a little bit surprising. This is not, nobody did that before the black rules from here. But the first option passing was put to black rules in the 76, and it was in continuous time. And then got the continuous time, simplified some simplify the black rules from here to get this binary.
Just to...
Because at that time, practitioners were maybe not able to use the black hole formula, they were not aware about the point of motion of the data. So you can pass to the test. Now, something that we have also to pay attention is what is called the self-referencing condition, which was used. During this methodology, we use the self-financing condition. So I should explain what is the self-financing condition, because it will be important to go to the time model. So, let us start with first branch, first step. So the investor has some wealth. And as I told you before, with that wealth, he invests on the market. So he chooses alpha and beta. He can choose an alpha and 0 to know his strategy to invest alpha in the dollar account and to hold beta share on the underlying asset. So at time one, the wealth is equal to 1 plus n. So I should put 0 here now. Alpha 0, 1 plus n plus beta 0 plus 1. And now at time one, the agent can decide, oh, I should do something else. It's better to invest in the underlying asset, or it's better to invest in the bank. So he will choose another portfolio. Because the West is the West. He has 500 million of dollars, time one, and he cannot have extra money. So he will change the portfolio, he will leave around the portfolio, and he can decide. Another strategy. Alpha 1 and beta 1, so that is equality also. So this can be put down as to the good notation, sorry. Alpha 0 is x minus beta 0 plus 0 times 1 f is beta 0 plus 0, and I can write it as x minus beta 0 plus 0 1 f. Also, and the wealth at time one, it would be like this. I do not have any more wealth, so I split my wealth into two parts. Alpha 1 so that I swing back, alpha 1, 1 plus L, 1 plus A, just to make it easier. In the bank account, and I should hold beta 1 share for this one. And the difference is now, here this alpha 1 and beta 0 were deterministic. Now this one can be deterministic, but they may depend on S1. If S1 is I mean here I know at tag 1 I should know what is the value of S1. So if S1 is upper state, I can see well the price is this asset, the good asset, because the price is increasing, so I should invest in the asset. And many people are doing that, not on one parallel model. But I know some people who are just trying to gamble with the market. And I met one of these people 2 years ago, 5 years ago. And he told me, I have a lot of money, I win a lot of money investing on the market. And my strategy is very simple. If the price of some asset increases during 3 days, I invest in the asset the following day. And he asked me, can you prove to me, you are mathematician, can you prove to me that it is a good strategy? Well, that's not cool. Maybe it's a good strategy because it was having a lot of money, winning a lot of money. I cannot prove that. Otherwise, it would be an arbitrary opportunity. And everybody will follow the same rule. So, after here, the alpha 1 and beta 1 can depend on S1. So I said that. So I should continue, and that term xk plus 1, and the x here is x0. So I term xk plus 1, I should ask that xk plus 1 is xk minus beta k plus k, 1 plus k, plus beta k, sk plus 1. And it just means that I do not add anything else too much weight. So if r equals 0, it will give me xk plus 1 minus xk equal beta k sk plus 1 minus sk. So the increment of xk, like I denote delta xk, xk plus 1 minus xk, is beta k delta sk. So when Nicole will go to the continuous time this afternoon, she will do the same, changing the delta into some derivative. And if L is not equal to 0, but you have to do something in order to have such a formula. And the something that you have to do is to look at the xk plus 1 over 1 plus L to the power k plus 1. So first I divide by 1 plus n. So xk plus 1 over 1 plus n minus xk is beta k sk plus 1 over 1 plus n minus sk. So this is not a nice formula because it's fully symmetric and I don't like the symmetric formula, but I should find xk plus 1 over 1 plus a to the power k plus 1 minus xk to the 1 over 1 plus a to the power k. So I should denote by x tilde k xk over 1 plus a to the power k. And I'm happy with that because this is the discounted value of xk. And xk is one f from time k, xk over 1 plus a to the power k is one f from time k. So I do, as a physicist, when you are learning physics at school, I'm sure that a physics teacher told you, you have to take attention, to pay attention to the unit. And if you have something which has a speed, you cannot say the speed is equal to a length. And you have to take care of the unit you are using. Here, that is the same. And if I would like to have a nice formula, I have to take care about the unit. And the usual way is to try to discount anything, any wealth, into Monero times zero. So that I have the same order of the wealth. I can compare two wealth. Equal, beta k, s tilde k plus 1, with the same notation for the s tilde, and s tilde k. So I should have delta x tilde k plus 1, and then beta k, delta s tilde k. So this is the self-financing condition. have something, it opens the door to a lot of research, very difficult research. And here, the main point is that I can buy and sell from the asset X of the fossil. The interest rate is the same for lending and loaning. It's not realistic. And reality, you know, that the two interest rates are different. If you do, if you try to limit this scenario to the case where there are two different interest rates, it would be very difficult because in that case I have to pretend about the sign of the alpha. So it would be very difficult. And that's not everything strategy and it would be difficult. The other thing, so this kind of subject is not investigated too much. There are some papers about that case, in particular some papers are involved, but it's not so many papers, maybe 10 papers, maybe 20 papers, no more. But something that's more challenging is to say that when you are selling or buying some asset, you have a transaction cost. And there is a price of the market. Think about the exchange rate. And there is a price of the exchange rate. But if you are doing to some shop to exchange the money, the exchange rate when you buy the money of and you sell them, it's not the same. And sometimes there is a transaction cost, you have to pay $2 each time you are a fixed one when you do a transaction and then change. So here there is no transaction cost. So you can think that you can have transaction cost. And you have beta zero S1 shares, beta zero shares of S1, and then you will change the beta zero to beta one, and then you have to pay a cost. And this cost can be usually the proportional cost. To go into beta zero is one share, would like to have beta one is one share, beta one is a beta zero share, would like to have beta one share, you have to pay a cost which is proportional to the strategy to the so maybe here you have to subtract beta one minus beta zero, kappa. So in that case, it's very difficult. You cannot edge perfectly, especially when you start. In this time, you cannot edge. You can succeed to have some post-form formula. But if you continue to start, it's obviously more difficult. If you continue to start, and each time you rebalance your portfolio, you have to pay transaction cost. Immediately, here, that you cannot do that in continuous style. And you cannot rebalance your portfolio in continuous style. Otherwise, the cost will be infinite. And so you will have to define some transaction boundary. And there is an area when you do not do any transaction. And so on. But this is the self-financing condition. Because in this setup, I understand, I hope that you understand very well why I have to impose this condition to the portfolio in order to be self-financing. And self-financing, the words are very clear. I do not have extra money, and I do not spend some money to go to the restaurant or to buy something. If you do that, and if at that point you decide, oh well, I have some money in the bank and in the SC market, and I would like to live your life, I would like to go to the restaurant, of course, the wealth decrease. You have here minus C1. C1 would be the potential. The self-identity condition in case when the agent is alone, you have to change a little bit to expect that you have to spend some money to do something else. So there are a lot of papers about that, especially when you would like to try to production. So the problem was to be, and you have some ways at time zero, X, and your goal is to invest in the market and in the bank account. In order, you have two goals. The first one is to be as rich as possible at the end. And the second goal is to consume as much as possible. So in that case, you have an optimization problem. It's not too difficult, but to use a Martingale approach is very useful. And okay, so the problem consumption and timing address are now always well understood. If the market is fully liquid, so fully liquid is exactly what I explained, I can buy as much of underlying asset that I want, no transaction cost, I can sell without any more thing, and you can solve this kind of problem. And in that case, the Martingale approach is very useful. So I feel that I forget to say it here something. In this handout, and we have proved that under the constant factor measure, the expectation of S1 over 1 to L. So since also here is a binomial tree multi-period, all the parameters P, U, D, and R are the same along the tree, the distance for probability will be of each branch of the tree the same one, P over 1 minus P and 1 minus P. So you will have also the expectation of S2 over 1 plus F will be S1. I use some space here because I have to do that. But here, it will be knowing where is S1. When I do the backward methodology on the tree, I'm assuming at each node of the tree that I know exactly on each node I want. So here, here that one, S1 and U. And knowing that I am S1 U, the expectation of the value of the underlying asset here is S1 U. The same here, knowing that I am S1 D, I know that the expectation will be S1 D. So I can concentrate these two conditions, claiming that the expectation of S2 given S1 is S1. Then I should have the expectation of S3 over 1 plus A, given S1 and S2 will be S2. I can forget S1 because I am part of the model. So what I have here, and if you have one number, two random variables is satisfied with the question, you can claim that S, the process S0, S1 is about. The process S0, S1, S0, S tilde 1, the S tilde 1 is S1 over 1 plus A, the process S0, S tilde 1 is a Martingale. Being a Martingale is two states, just the expectation of the second term is equal to the first one. And here, I should add that S0, S tilde 1, and so on, S tilde n is a Martingale. Under the distance for probability. And so, another point, when you are doing optimization theory, usually it's not under the distance for probability. Because optimization under the distance for probability, you are risk control. So you would like to optimize the wealth and the risk control probability. By definition of risk control, you can prove that you are risk control. So you are indifferent between investing in the market or investing in all your wealth in the bank account. If you want to prove that, it's due to complexity as you want, so I should not enter into this case. So usually, when people are interested with optimization, they are working on the historical probability, the true probability. And not this tool, to do pricing. And again, if you would like to play some risk measurement, and usually the risk measurement is not done under the system for probability. And for it is a topic. The risk measurement under the historical probability. So this is a story about the multi-period model. And of course, on the multi-period model, you can do a lot of different things. You can use other option. And if you are interested with that, there is a book by Elliot and Koch where you can find all the computation of any kind of option on the binomial tree. So you can do what you want. And assume that the C, the claim is an option, whole option or two option. You can assume that the C is the C at the end. And here, if I compose the maximum. So the C at the end depends on the parasitic follow, and it will be the maximum of the C, the n value of the type. Or the average, 1 over capital N, sum of the Cn. Or whatever you want, it should be some eigenvector, it should be some maximum of change, some quotient of change. And what you can do also, because I shall not speak too much about that, the American option. So this is on the core American option. So the payoff is C, I should write C2 minus K, positive power, if you decide to stop or to exercise the option at time 2. So, of course, it's a bit bigger. So, this is the same story as the European option. A European option, the payoff is C, the capital option is S. The payoff of the European option will be S at time capital A minus K positive part. And the American option, if you buy an American option, you are allowed to ask at any time between 0 and the natural T to ask to the seller of the option, or today, I will have the payoff of today. So you choose the top. The seller of the option sells the product, and the buyer of the option can claim at any time between 0 and capital L, I would have to exercise the option. He will ask to the seller, please give me the money to me. For core American option, you can prove that the price of the core American option is the price of the European option, and the best top, and we have to optimize the top, the best top is capital N. This is because of complexity are moved. But for a good, so this is why you will never find. I was looking yesterday on the web, and it was very funny. There was some forum, and one, if you Google a core American, price of the core American option, if you Google, press, in the forum, some question asked by people, why is the price of the core American option equal to the price of the core European option? And it's true that it's not so easy to find the answer in textbook and something that is well known. And I found some proofs in textbook, but so sometimes the proofs are very difficult and you can't fully appreciate. I was telling that the price of the core American option is the price of the core European option, but it's not easy to find the reference in textbook. Not so easy at all. And the proof I found is so difficult. It's supposed, in some textbooks the page is 2 pages long. Oh, maybe you can discuss that about the next time. But for the good option, it's really different. And so this is why if you go to papers, we'll find a lot of papers on the price of the good, but no paper on the price of the good, but then nothing to do. And the thing to do is to find the best tool. So in this time, it's not so difficult, but we have to find the price in advance. But in cooking with carbs, and this is still, I would say, open problem to find in a closed form formula the price of the put option and the price of the value of the top in a closed form, even in a cashless model. So, I'm not speaking about that anymore.
Anneliese. So now you can add your idea. My new tree is a little bit simple. So I should do this on something. Musical. So now I think my attention to the case where S can take two values, but if S can take more than two values. And we should look at the case with three values. And then we can take as many values as you want. So M is 0, M is middle. I don't think that M is equal to 0, it's just a value suggestion into the M into the M. And what are the difficulties? And I should take M equal 0. Just to simplify the question. So you can say, well, easy. I should go to Egypt. I should try to A. If I succeed to A, maybe I will succeed. That will be easy. So Egypt. To find alpha and beta and this. So that. Alpha 1 plus A plus beta S1 is equal to the value of the covariant chain. Now we have three values of the covariant chain. Cu, Cm, and Ce. So if we see, I can watch it. So if we see me, I find the first equation.
Usually, there are two cases. Either you can find at least one solution, But usually, if you can find one solution, well, in fact, you have both solutions. So either you have two solutions, but if you have no solution, you can prove it's not that you have to work and to do. You can prove that there are arbitrary opportunities. There is some work to do, right? It's not us. Either you have anything in your global solution. And in that case, of course, you can compute the expectation of the chaos under one of these probabilities, but you will get a lot of answer. So you will get the expectation on the P of C. Can take different values. So what you can prove, again it's not a direct argument, but the proof was given by Nicole, is you can look at the smallest, again n equals 0, the smallest value among all the p we satisfy these two conditions, you can go to the supernode. You get an interval, of course. And usually you can prove that any number C0 belongs to this interval, then there are no arbitrary opportunities. And you sell or buy C0 is the price of the C, then there are no arbitrary opportunities. If C0 does not belong to this interval, you have arbitrary opportunity. So this interval is often called the interval of viable spans. And any C0 in this interval can be obtained with the ad hoc probability. So this is not an obvious method, but very interesting method. And the other interesting method is that the supremum of this one here. This is also part of the material just because. So, associate that in the zero. This is the idea of pricing using the equivalent Mappinger measure. Now we can go back to the edging and say, well, I am the seller of some sort of thing. I sell to one of you the contact on there. I should receive some money. And with that money, I should invest in the market in order to get at the end an amount of money fit enough to pay you the value of the trade. So the seller has C at price C0, and the buyer needs to receive C at the end. So I have to say that, I receive C0, and I know in advance that I have to give you back C at the end. So I have no money in my pocket for the moment. So I receive the C0, and I should invest in the market. And the seller invests in the market. So that, the wealth of the seller at the terminal date, capital P plus capital, is at least greater than C. For the worst, if I cannot invest in the market so that my terminal wealth is greater than C, I should lose money. And I don't want to sell you something knowing in advance I should lose money. If I can hedge perfectly, course, I would like to say to the good Agent Dame that if I pass, it would be my own interest, so that I should have a large benefit, but you are asking her as me, and you will not agree to pay the say to my price. If I can duplicate that in front, it's N, it's C, is identical. The buyer will not buy C at Xn at the price. Xn is Xn at the price of X0. If X0 is greater than the return of the price of C. Because you are asked about me, and if this inequality before, you do the disagree because you can invest in the market by yourself, even if you are too lazy to do that. We assume that the investor is not lazy, and you will have the same final payoff for all our funds. So we're not able to do that. And this is why the price of the coal is the agent's actually the fair price. But here, so I shall introduce this asymmetry as the seller of the price. I agree to sell you something that is not available to some price if the terminal payoff that I can realize investing in the market is greater than the amount of money that I should pay. And of course I should take the smallest one because I'm going to be honest. So I would like to do not make loss, but not to make a huge benefit. So you can find the upper super hedging price, the super hedging price. Is the smallest X0 initial weight so that Xn, so that there is a strategy. Alpha beta. With alpha plus beta L0 equals X0, and alpha 1 plus L plus beta L1 with beta L1. Here I will back to get to the final. From this set time. Okay. One thing. Otherwise, I have to describe the wealth at the end as the initial wealth plus the benefit that I can use in the set time of the equation. And it's possible to prove that this operating part, in fact, is the supremum of the whole technical probability of our C. So this is a nice theory that proves you that the two approaches are more limited and not more. That is the same, and this is a not so difficult, this is based on some duality theory. So this is the end of what I would say to you. On this, and I think we should stop here. So I can, yeah, because some of you asked me questions about the KTs, so I can ask just some words about KTs for those of you who are okay, I'm not ending to talk about anything, so I can just give the main idea. So, stop here for 3 years. Of course, it remains a lot of things to do, but as a proof of this, all these results are not so easy, and I need more than 10 minutes to do that. But just we learn how to ask the rules about PDP, because there are a lot of things that I do with you. And I thought that was a model used by practitioners in order to model a single default and then four models with the default. And maybe some research are there. So as I told you, in the previous talk, in order to predict it, ce sont les approches. Yeah, a lot of examples, but not really the full methodology, because cross-form formulae are not accessible. So then you can do some units if you want. But again, usually these models are difficult to calibrate to the data. The data is the CDS prices, and the bar or CDO prices. So in the default, and I cannot go into default to enter in the stochastic calculus area. So then the toy model, again the toy model is not the conditional, but the toy model is not rich enough. So to assume that you have somewhere some different thing set, the value of the form, at least you are looking at this, the dynamic of this asset without taking care about the result. So we have A is B equals B is B, the single B is B, the single B is B. So then, you have some filtration for at least resistance. If they can have suppression, if they have suppression, this is given by your model. Without any model, I cannot do anything. Ah, it can be, for example, the filtration given by the traversion of default free zone components, when the interest rate is not deterministic. So you have to find your favorite model. To model interest rate, you can go to the Jarre-Mouton model, whatever you want model, to model the price of different free zone coupon, saying the each Jarre-Mouton model in order that interest rate is the best. And then you would like to define the model, and again it's a mathematical model for the default. So the model which is in the 95% of the backup is that one. So it defined as the first time when the integral of the probability is from that SPS, and people that this random variable theta, where theta is independent of f, and exponential law is just to have nice formulae, so independent is just to construct the model. And why again, there is no economic reason, it's just because it produces cross-form formula for pricing, and then you have to calibrate your model. Usually, I would ask the question, what kind of formula can you take? I think it's up to you. Any process which is non-negative. So in the literature, usually CIR model. Veranda plays a role of some interest rate. So you must be able to solve the same problem with some stochastic interest rate. And stochastic interest rate, CIR model, some kind of people are looking for time-limited model, but in your time-limited model, the interest rate can be negative. So it is doable, that's still financial meaning, but at this rate, I cannot feel the intensity negative. So apart CIR model, or, of course, if you can take any Bessel process or whatever, the maximum motion is not true. Because it's too difficult to calibrate the data. So, now, one paper is a geometric Borgen motion, it's called a double. donner le mot. One or two papers d'auteur modèle. Qui déclare là as a geometric Boolean motion. That's the model. But first, it's difficult to keep the data, and second, we have some difficulties to compute, because if you do that, I will have to compute at some point, we have to compute the law or something like that. And this is similar to Asian Ocean, and it's well known that to find the law of this quantity is very difficult, to do numerics with that quantity is very difficult. And yes, we are getting to do not have a score at the time. The score for the final. Otherwise, you can discount time with CIR process. Because in CIR process, you can at least compute some quantities. So, in that, so, something that I can't explain carefully here. So, I shall explain that now. Now, I assume that I would like to know the class of a derivable zero coupon. In order to find the class of something, I have to define the class of the traded asset. So the traded asset at one, and there is no default here. So I cannot find an hedging strategy. I cannot hedge the two because if I would like to hedge this kind of quantity, which means that I have to find some asset with a terminal value of the asset is indicator function of capital T smaller than 2. That 2 contains some bound of the theta. Because the integral from the multiple of lambda is dx equals theta. Take lambda deterministic, lambda constant, just to understand. I could have told T lambda equals theta. So lambda equals theta. So the tau will be theta over lambda. So the tau is something which is independent of the thing. So I cannot add. And so the goal leads to find the class of the different probabilities. So what practitioners are doing? They apply the control probability methodology. And they choose their favorite control probability. How? This is their no, as they must have the feeling that they are choosing the best one. So what do we find? We find that expectation of indicator, so actually the expectation T smaller than 2 into the power of 2. We have to discount this quantity, given the information, so GT is information, is a T. So at time 0, the price will be expectation T smaller than 2 into the power from the price of 0 to x over the price at time 0. And I have to compute this quantity. So this is quite easy. This quantity is expectation of e to the power minus bc expectation of indicator function of t smaller than 2 given the tau root. This is the tau root for positional expectation. And this quantity belongs to ft because ft contains all the information about the prices I can see in the market. And since I claim that I am stochastic interest rate, I can observe this stochastic interest rate up to time capital T. And this is T, so this is what I proved last week. Because of that definition of the two, this is the computation I did last week. And again, this proof is made in two parts. The first part is using that theta is independent of f, and there is a part using that theta is an exponential law. This is why there is exponential of minus an integral of the lambda here. Otherwise, we should have a closed form formula, but it will be e to the power e. For n is the rest, and it will be g level D from the NPS, and where G of theta of X will be the probability that capital theta is equal to and the law that the exponential law, you can do the computation, and the final formula and result. So, since the model is not a model of the reality, it's just a model to be able to do the computation, let us make the model as simple as possible. But what is important, and I did not mention that strongly enough last week, is that here the lambda is the lambda corresponding to the Christoffel probability, to the match of the Christoffel probability. If I change the Christoffel probability, I have to change the lambda. And you can see this to take n equals 0, so you have to take probability expectation of indicators in the this is the expectation of e to the power integral of the lambda. And you can prove that the lambda s is in fact the limit of 1 over h probability of 2 belongs between t and t plus h given the information probability. So if I change my probability, I also change the lambda. So the lambda is strongly linked with the choice we have done, and is even an equivalent to any of that, the choice we have done for the central probability. And so this is really, we forget everything about the aging strategy to find the price, and to find the price, the practitioner choose one central probability. So they calibrate, then they calibrate the lambda with the sum. With the price. So they choose one lambda and they give the price of something. And even if they don't tell you what is the choice of the lambda, with the price of the liberty, you can recover the lambda that the practitioner is used to try the CDS or whatever. And this is a very specific model. I fully agree with that. But this is what practitioners are doing. And now you can think, well, as soon as I can do that logically, again, for computational issue, it's not so easy, and look, just the price of a different table 0.2, and you have to find this expectation. And if L is stochastic and lambda is, if L is deterministic, you just have to find this expectation. But there are not so many examples of positive process when you can find this expectation in the closed form. And then it's a very difficult question. And Marco has used, he was trying to say, can we solve the following problem? Integral from 0 to 1 of some function of Bs, Bs is the random motion, Bs. Can we solve the log prime, the log of this quantity? And Mario, who was an expert in computation of law, anything about Brownian motion, to the best of his knowledge, which was a very heavy large, he succeeded to have a closed form solution, maybe the Laplace transform of this quantity, a closed form solution for this integral for six different f. Of course, f equal identity, f equal exponential, f equal f1 if b is positive, f of x equal a if x is positive and minus b if x is negative. Hyperbolic cosine, and the last one, six examples. So not very easy. Because when f is exponential, I see the exponential is a lift. Bs, b to the power minus bs, is very difficult. Well, to take as that, it's also very, very difficult. And so, the choice of the lambda is not so easy. So now, what if you do, we'd like to have several defaults.
So if they are still in that methodology, they will say, well, we should define the flow. But now, if they face a problem, they have to correlate the lambda I, and second, they have to correlate the theta. So it's not so easy. And if they do that, they bring the lambda I with the same methodology, F-adaptive process, there is something that is missing in that model, is that the intensity of the name number one does not depend on the intensity of the name number two. And usually intensity are correlated, not only because they are extremely vulnerable, but the intensity of the firm depends strongly on the behavior of the firm, if the two firms are correlated. And I was always explaining to my students, so to give examples, if you are where the part producing typing machine, all typing machines, then computers are coming on the market, and if you are producing only all typing machines, one company can default, and the other company producing also typing machine, or quite sure that you will default also very soon. So it doesn't mean that nobody is buying typing machine anymore. And so if one company default, it can announce forthcoming default for you and which are your intensity. The intensity, the probability of default, the intensity will increase. Because you know that the other company has defaulted. It can be the reverse. In Sweden, 5 years ago, some domestic fly company get into bankruptcy. Okay, two companies, cheap domestic fly, and one of the company defaulted. But for the other company, it was a chance. Because they were happy that the other company is defaulted, because they have all the customers for themselves. And so they were very happy, and their intensity was decreasing. So you have to limit the intensity. So you cannot use this model anymore. Now you have some difficulties. And the thing I have not mentioned strongly enough is that the choice of the intensity, if you are willing to have this kind of computation, and the choice of the intensity depends, not clearly of, but I should give something, some results that I did not show last week, but prove that the choice of the intensity depends on the information that you have at hand. Now, again, historical things, this model can use, and you find a nice formula. I show some formula like this, everything is nice, you find a nice formula. Especially that formula. And we can use that to price something, we have just to change the interest rate, adding the intensity. But you can do, and there is more intensity comes from that, than indicator of tau polar quantity minus integral from 0 to t epsilon tau of lambda LTS is a Martingale. No. Mathematical finance people are Martingale numbers. Is a Martingale. In the compression, Ft supplements the knowledge. I don't try that mathematical term of two. And it means that you observe Ft, which is a reflection of the prices. So Ft means that you know all the default free prices up to 20. So two is not included in Ft, because if you observe the price of default free prices, you don't observe the default. And here I ask that I observe the default and the default of. So it changes by the interaction. And you can prove that property. But now you really have to pay attention that this is the definition of the intensity. Mathematical definition of the intensity. As for the Poisson process. As for the Poisson process, and T minus lambda T is Martingale, and lambda is called the intensity. So mimicking this definition, this
standby for the
vacancy.
Vacancy. But now, if I have several defaults, I should have a lot of information set in my account. So I should have the information on this one. For each default, I can associate to each default the intensity of the default. But when you have a martingale with some filtration, this martingale does not come in martingale with another filtration. So the intensity depends also on the information. And you can move from models with the intensity is deterministic to models for the same default time where the intensity is stochastic. So when you have multi-default, you have to be careful about in which filtration you are working. So it's that more or less very difficult, and that should just end to, and we say work in progress in the policies. I can say that. With Nicole and the student of Nicole, we are trying to have a general model of multi-default. So we succeed with that, but it's not so easy to obtain those form solutions. And I should just end with that. This is a paper that some of you have received who are working on that. And this model is very specific. And this model is very specific. So what you can do from a mathematical point of view, in a general way, and this model is used in some papers in science, say, well, general model, of course, it's not the more general model that special. I have shown you some regularity. But you can say, well, what I mean is that thing. For any t, yes. So I assume that I have a recurrent filtration, and I assume that for any t, any f, I know that quantity. So I assume that default. For multi-default, I should assume that I know.
Okay.
disais, je ferai d'autres exemples.
Le fort,
fils, S, je aime S, donc. Vous dites crazy, je fais tout.
If
If I have to think a little bit before giving an answer, I can forget. So in that case, do not hesitate to send me an email. And the other thing I would like to apologize is that when I answer to me, I am not kind enough. I should not tell you to the student. I am very happy that you send me a mail and so on. I should send the answer and talk to you. So I am not polite at all, but otherwise I cannot answer to with the mail. It's a choice.